Welcome to my exhibition online. This first piece I'm going to show you is called the Sacred Book Series. It's five panels with small sculptures from my Wabi Sabi series. They're the covers of the books. The interior of the book is encrusted in glass in another piece, and each piece represents the knowledge, the history we find in books, the stories of all of us. This is called Teaism. It's a piece that I made using tea bags, dried tea bags, and it's in the shape of an hourglass, so it represents the shape of a woman. And Teaism is a Japanese philosophy, and it relates to the equilibrium and the balance, and especially about the ephemeral quality of life. And this piece is very fragile, and it is very sensitive to the lightest movement. When you walk by it, it's very alive. And the centerpieces are, if you look closely, are rosy peachy colored, which represent the interior of a woman, and the sculpture is a woman. This piece is a series of three boxes, my gypsy and grain boxes, and the subject is about blind children. When I worked with blind children a number of years ago, they're very tactile pieces with river-washed bricks, with pins and little stories with Baba Black Sheep story and songs. This is represents the interior world of the blind children, made with glass, wax, water-washed bricks. This is a feminine flag, a woman's flag. It's made with lace and an old tableau from school with writing. If you look very closely, there's writing, there's traces of the past, broken glass. The center is also a sculpture from my Wabi Sabi collection. This is Zeus's golden rain, made with rapeseed stalks, which I've applied gold leaf to the roots, and it represents a myth where Zeus wanted to seduce Princess Danae, but Princess Danae's father locked her in a tower, and Zeus had to transform himself into golden rain to penetrate between the bars, and they conceived of Perseus. So it's a piece that's very represents fertility, represents, it's very masculine, in fact. Now we enter the world of gloves. I've been working with gloves and collecting them from local flea markets for several years now. And I did a piece called The Language of Gloves, Langage des Gants. And it's a manual on how to flirt using gloves. And for example, you can take your gloves and you can caress them very gently. And that means, I would like to speak with you. And they're all there's a whole language revolving around gloves. So that was fun. And during the exhibition, I had a antique wooden box with gloves and all sorts of gloves attached with elastics. And I encouraged people to play with the gloves, to take them, and I tried to help them learn how to flirt. My black glove panel I call les chausseries du soir, which are bats from the evening. And what I like are the negative spaces, the opposite of the white gloves, the shapes. And this is my lost glove piece, which is all about lost children and kidnapping and sort of parents' nightmares. This is called Ovum. It's made of fiberglass and steel. The outside is covered with antique marbles that I found and little tiny quail eggs that I've embedded with little bits of broken glass. It's a piece that rotates upon itself, and it also represents the world, the fertility. Here you see my quail eggs, and you can imagine how long it took to do this piece. This is a detail of My Size Barbie, which is a sewn sculpture, which is about 3.5 meters high. And I used my collection of doll clothes, which I've sewn together over a metal and fabric armature with an inside pink lighting. And I did this piece because I thought it was interesting that Barbie was the first doll that was made to represent an adult. All the other dolls before that were always babies or children. So this is my vision of a My Size Barbie. here is my leather installation, and it represents a crazy leather sorceress who is tired of sewing and is just in upheaval and is swallowing the chair below her. And it's an environment totally in leather. And you sort of see through the waving bits of leather at the rest of the show. These are my three desperate housewives. The first one is the young mother, and it's made of baby clothing all sewn together with millions of little buttons suspended, and the shadow is also made of buttons. The second one is the housewife who's very tired of cooking with the rice shadow, and it's made of my grandmother's recipe cards that I've sewn all together. And the third one is the biological woman, and she's made of watch boxes and clocks, barometers, very tautly tied together, the tension of sort of the end of the reproduction time. And her shadow is made of canning jars filled with a red liquid. And then the whole process of putting together an installation involves many, many helping hands and takes a long time. This is the Cardaire installation. I call it the bird cabaret because the common name for this plant is the bird cabaret, as it's a plant that's very important to nature in times of drought. It can contain up to 1 liter of water in each plant, and each head has about 500 grains, so it's very fertile. Therefore, I put on the ground little tiny cups filled with water and birdseed. And this, I tied together a number of panels together, and it seems to float in the environment. It's very alive. This is my chestnut shell evening gown, all sewn together with brass wire and sitting on a bed of bay leaves. It was very painful to make, prickling my fingers. And this is a piece about medusas and the effect of global warming, as we find in our bodies of water more and more medusas. This I made with all sorts of antique lace and antique clothing and fiberglass resined medusas. This is my quail egg evening gown, made of branches sewn together with resin quail eggs. And if you'd like to see more, please visit my website where you can see many more pieces at pamelamoulton.com. And thank you so much for visiting my show.